All right, welcome to Lab 3. In this lab, we'll focus on Galileo's two most famous discoveries. The first being that, for the first time in the history of history, someone discovered new worlds out there in space, these being the four large moons of Jupiter. Galileo was also the first to measure the phase and angular size of Venus, and how these quantities change as Venus moves through its orbit. So we'll tackle both of these in this lab. Now, for the past week or two, you've been monitoring a moon going around one of the gas giants. It doesn't have to be Jupiter, it can be any of the four. In this lab, you'll use Afterglow and the skills you've already developed to measure how far that moon is from its planet, and how this angular distance varies with time. Using these data, you'll then quantify the orbit of the moon. You'll measure its semi-major axis, or in other words, how large the orbit is, and you'll measure its orbital period, how long it takes for the moon to complete an orbit. Using these quantities, you'll then calculate the mass of the central body, the planet, using Kepler's third law, or more specifically, Newton's form of Kepler's third law. How massive must that planet be for the moon to orbit that quickly at that distance? Now, in the second part of this lab, you'll use one of the images that you took from lab one, your image of Venus, if you got it, and you'll supplement this with images of Venus that Skynet staff have already taken for you, taken at different positions in Venus's orbit. For each of these images, you'll measure the phase and angular size of Venus. And using this information, you'll determine whether we live in a geocentric universe or a heliocentric universe. Now, while you're doing this, it's important that your instructor put in the group observations for Lab 4. In Lab 4, among other things, you're going to measure the distance to a main belt asteroid. And you're going to do this by observing this asteroid simultaneously from two telescopes, one in the northern hemisphere and one in the southern hemisphere. You'll then measure its distance using a technique called parallax. Achieving that simultaneity is very difficult and requires special priority access. We've either already given this to your instructor or will do so quickly upon their request. Your instructor will then put in this observation for the entire group to share when you begin Lab 4. All right, that's it.